Hello there guys, my name is Coaster Child, Donkster Born, Bob Bill for Theme Parks, and welcome to a Theme Park Newsroom update, where today we're going to be discussing what I would do if I was to rebuild Lightwater Valley for a family thrill audience. Now, I'm not saying I'm not happy with the direction they're going. I know a lot of people have their concerns, you know, or if you take out loads of thrill rides, put in family rides, give it a couple of years like American Adventure, it's going to go south. But if Lightwater Valley do it right, the family direction could be the right direction and probably the only direction they could have gone in the current market. However, that doesn't mean I can't sort of rebuild the park myself. So what I decided to do is, I took screenshots from Google Maps of each and every area, well not each and every area, but the areas of the park that I want to see developed further. And I'm going to be recreating these areas, sharing my thoughts on what I would put in these specific areas. Now, of course, this does include the removal of Raptor Attack, Eagle's Claw, Wild River Rapids, Apollo, and obviously Black Pearl. So all those rides will be gone anyway. So they're not included. They're all gone in this rebuild. So we're gonna fill this areas up with brand new rides and attractions for family and thrills. We're gonna share my thoughts on what I would like to see add in each area. Now, before we get started with this very, very long video, make sure you like the video if you loved it, comment down below your thoughts and opinions, subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss another YouTube video. We are getting closer and closer to 4,000 subscribers by the end of the year and 1 million views as well by the end of the year. So please, 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 let's make this happen. Also, guys, stay tuned because we've got plenty more videos coming your way, plenty more news updates. I'm sure we'll try and get some Coast Child chats booked as well. If any theme park manufacturers or theme parks watching this, or you know, any celebrities that end up watching this that want to talk about their theme park trips, or any music concerts they've done at theme parks, or any, you know, meet and greets they've done at theme parks, then please, please, please please email me at any point. The email's in the about section of the channel, and please email me because it'd be great to get you on the channel as part of the Coast Child chat series. Also, guys, check the description down below for Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, and Snapchat links, and also the Discord server link where you, yes, you, the Coast Child fanbase, can be a part of the channel and interact with the Coast Child fanbase, the Child Nation, using the server. And also, guys, use the Google Forms link in the description down below to submit your video ideas and for you to get a shout out. They'll all be pre-recorded in the summer. And for now, guys, let's have a look exactly about my redevelopment of Lightwater Valley Theme Park. So we're kicking off with the entrance area of the park. This is the current entrance sign and area. Now, I would like to see it redeveloped into a more wonderfully displayed archway. I'd like to see a completely redeveloped Lightwater Valley entrance arch with brand new ticket kiosks, brand new turnstiles, and overall just a more polished entrance front, in my opinion. I think it should look a bit more stylish, like a proper themed park. Next up, the former entrance building and the play area next to it. Straight away, demolish the play area next to it. Straight away, I'd demolish it. And I'd also demolish the current former entrance building, which has now got a couple of indoor play areas in for the kids. I'd demolish that as well. And I would build a brand new building on both sites, which will host either a flying theatre or a Vekoma Madhouse. This is something like Hex at Alton Towers or The Haunting at Drayton Manor, something like that. And in a family-friendly way, the storyline is an abandoned hotel haunted by lost souls. So we're looking here at a family-friendly storyline based on that story. So that is what I would do with a brand new building on both those sites, the former entrance building and the play area next to it as well. I'd demolish both outside and indoor, and inside and outside, and create a brand new building to host this brand new flying theatre or Vekoma Madhouse. I'd probably go with the Madhouse because I think it's a better attraction in my opinion from the looks of it anyway. The flying theatre's got room for development, no doubt about that, and I'd probably add that in the park in the future. But the Vekoma Madhouse probably works for that building. Especially if you retheme the golf course next door, because you could retheme that and retheme that to like a Transylvania golf course or something, and sort of bring the dinosaur theming somewhere else in the park. So I've got room for that dinosaur theming, which I'll tell you about in a little bit. But I'd like to see maybe like a haunted house golf course next door, so it's like a spooky themed area as soon as you walk into the park. So that would be nice, especially for Halloween events as well. You could have a nice Halloween bunting going up, and you see Halloween actors walking around during the October period in that entrance walkway, getting ready for the guests to come into the park. And it'd be wonderful, wouldn't it? Next up, the barn area behind the former entrance building where I think the Madhouse will go. And this will be for a brand new themed area of the theme park. So this will be a brand new area. You can see the area on your screen. It's quite a massive area. At the minute, it's got like a crossover bridge going into the petting. It's currently a petting barn, I believe. So you currently got that. Got some other little things here as well, but overall I think there's a lot that can be done. So what I decided to do is I've listed a few attractions here: a Zamperla Discovery Revolution, so a frisbee ride, a Vekoma Family Boomerang Coaster, and two or three family slash kids rides. And this would all be a farmyard area, and the reason why is because I'm retheming the tractors later on and getting rid of Eagles Creek Farm, and I'll tell you why. I'd maybe bring the Eagles Creek Farm sort of theme up into this area, create a brand new farmyard area or themed farmyard area, and have these sort of attractions themed to farmyard animals. So maybe the frisbee ride is like a spotted cow type theme. So it's like the or just a normal barnyard theme, like themed to a barnyard power generator, like a barnyard storm force or something like that. And obviously there's a few kids rides you could put in there, maybe like one of those Zamperla kiddie happy swing attractions that's listed on the website. Maybe a Zamperla barnyard attraction would be wonderful. It would fit the area as well. So overall then, a farmyard area, a proper farmyard area with barn animals and things like that, would be a wonderful theme for the area. And of course you can have some nice 3D animatronics of farmyard animals in there as well, and overall it would be a wonderful area. Next up, the Eagles Creek Farm area, and this is where I bring the dinosaur theming up to, because I'd like to see the tractors rethemed, maybe extend the layout quite a bit, and then where Eagle's Claw is and the area behind the tractor ride, I'd like to see a brand new dinosaur themed suspended family coaster, something like Dragon Flare at Dollywood in the Wildwood Grove section, and themed around dinosaurs, themed around the prehistoric era. It would be wonderful to see that light water line. I think it would be a wonderful addition to the park, because you could even go down the suspended thrill coaster route, maybe put an inversion in there if they wanted to for the thrill market, so there's something for the teens. But overall I think the prehistoric theme moving into this area would be the best way forward in my opinion, and I think that it would be the best use of the site. Next up, skate carts, rapids, jumping pillow and twister are all, well, the jumping pillow is still there, but the rest of them are gone or going. And I'd like to see a couple of rides come into here. The Zamperla Air Race and Zamperla Nebula's attraction, I'd see that coming in there, maybe where the skate carts is. But where the twister is and the rapids is, they're stretching from the twister to the rapids and including the jumping pillow attraction as well, a Mac Power Splash. That would be wonderful for the park. So I'd put the two Zamperla rides, the Air Race and the Nebulas, where the skate carts is. Where that brown old maze is, maybe a new attraction there as well. So maybe another Zamperla attraction, or maybe you get a Mac attraction in there. But I'd see a Power Splash where stretching from where Twister is to the Rapids site is, including the jumping pillow as well. And I'd like to see a Mac Power Splash stretching across there. Maybe not an attraction where the brown maze is, because maybe that's like a splash area for when the main finale of the Power Splash is. But I'd like to see a Mac Power Splash on one side and two Zamperla attractions, the Nebulas and the Air Race, on the other side. Next up, Skeleton Cove needs a redo, and I think that overall, Black Pearl's obviously gone. There's a bit of area, like an old playground next to behind Black Pearl, like a newer playground behind Black Pearl. I'd like to see that gone as well, maybe put a brand new attraction in there. This would be the brand new reborn Skeleton Cove. This would be brand new pirate themed ride, so you keep the old, keep the current ones, maybe the waltzer and the sand digger play area go as well, put a nice attraction in there. Obviously the playground and the Black Pearl area could go, in my opinion. It'd be nice to put like a couple of family attractions in there, maybe some Zamperla ones, maybe you call SBF Visa, maybe get one of those drop towers, remove trauma towers from the park and maybe put an SBF Visa family thrill drop tower, like a Magma at Poulton's Park, or maybe a Zamperla version, so something like Croc Drop that's going into Chessington this year. Either where the Thunderdome Waltzer and the Sand Pit playground is, or where Black Pearl and the playground behind it is. So either of those areas could work for the drop tower, especially with the queue line and exit area. Maybe even re-theme the Splash Falls, which used to be known as Falls of Terror. Maybe even re-theme that to the Pirates theme. Even bring that sort of thing in. And that's actually the area we're going to go to right now. So sort of a part two then for the Skeleton Cove is where Splash Falls is. And I'd like to see an attraction next to it. And maybe we could see a Zamperla Disco Coaster at this park. That'd be wonderful, wouldn't it? I think the Zamperla Disco Coaster themed to Pirates along with a re-themed Splash Falls to Pirates would be wonderful. Maybe where the Sandpit Playground is, if the drop tower's going where Black Pearl and the playground behind it is, maybe the Sandpit Playground gets transformed and that whole strip of land near where the trees are, in between the trees, could be transformed into like a classic Panning for Gold attraction. Something classic like that. Or maybe it becomes a stage for a pirate show for entertainment value. So overall, there's some really good possibilities for that particular area of the park as a phase two to the reborn, redeveloped Skeleton Cove. If you like it, give me an R in the comments down below. Next up, the area where Apollo is. That ride is going back on the travelling circuit, in my opinion, so we need a replacement ride. And they could go back to the classic days of Lightwater Valley, bringing in a permanent, from scratch, Mondial Top Scan. Something like Whirlwind used to be at Lightwater Valley, at the old Lightwater Valley. Whirlwind back at the park. That would be wonderful. But if you look, that area is very, very big, so you could even put a family ride in one bit of the area and Whirlwind over most of the site anyway. So you could even put another family ride in there and theme it to natural disasters. So maybe Earthquake and have it like a couple of mini drop towers like Peter Rabbit's Hibbity Hop at Alton Towers. Maybe that goes in along with Whirlwind as like a natural disaster mini area. So something that would collage together really, really well. This is the one you've all been waiting for, I'm sure. It's the ultimate roller coaster. What would I do with it? If there is unlimited budget, and that's the whole thing with this development video, with this redevelopment video, this rebuild discussion update. If there is unlimited funds, I could see two things done to it. Either one. I would do either GCI Titan Track, if the supports are strong enough to hold it. Or, again, if the supports are strong enough to hold it, RMC Topper Track. Now, again, I could be absolutely bonkers. Maybe get GCI or RMC to redevelop the whole thing. That would be wonderful. But I think if there was unlimited funds, I would get RMC to do the whole thing. And you've got to think the Ultimate's a massive area. On show right now is just the station area. But the rest of the area is so long, you could turn it in before you go into the woodland and do some nice elements. And I think we are probably looking at the first ever double lift hill singular RMC roller coaster, because the only other RMCs with two lift hills is the Twisted Colossus Mobius Loop dueling coaster, so at Six Flags Magic Mountain. So in terms of one RMC and not a Mobius Loop or two separate tracks, we're looking at a two lift hill, which is a first for those singular solo RMC coasters. So I think that would be wonderful. Or GCI comes in, Titan Tracks it like they're doing with current wooden coasters like White Lightning. They're going to do it to Predator at Darien Lake as well. That would be wonderful, especially if the supports can hold it. They could do some nice Titan Track and sort of retrack it a little bit. So overall, the Ultimate is primed and ready for redevelopment, especially with it being SBNO this year. And finally, lights, camera, action. Where Raptor Attack once stood, we welcome you to Lightwater Studios, the film studio of the valley. Now, this is, again, playing on the Movie Park Studios attraction opening this year at Movie Park Germany. I'd like to see a movie set themed dark coaster, intimate multidimensional, themed around the Lightwater Studios. Or maybe they go for a different kind of theme. Nothing too sinister like raptors and dinosaurs, because obviously we've got this dinosaur area that I talked about earlier. But maybe they go with a Wild Western area. Maybe they go in this journey and they go into this old abandoned mine and they tell the story of an old Western figure. This shadowy Western gunslinger that came to the old Valley of Lightwater. I'm trying to do my best Wild West impression. Came back to the old Valley of Lightwater to streak his vengeance on anyone who steps in his way. So it'd be wonderful to have that Wild West comeback revenge story theme going along, especially with the Interbin multidimensional. And it's sort of like, in terms of like a drop track element, maybe it's sort of up on another floor of the building. It's sort of, so the building's obviously higher, but it's sort of on like one bit, and it's sort of like that part of the story feels like you're hiding in the attic from him, and it's sort of like he shoots down the attic doors and you sort of get blown down and you sort of have to go backwards to escape the gunslinger. That would be a wonderful way to play into the drop track element and the backward section involved with that afterwards as well. So I think that a nice Wild West rootin' tootin' theme for families, for Lightwater Valley, and that would be brilliant. Sort of stepping into the old Lightwater mine or the Lightwater saloon, and he's sort of experiencing the revenge and the wrath of the gunslinger for the very first time. So it's like a wonderful attraction. So with that and every single other one of these investments, Lightwater Valley will definitely become a better theme park. So ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, that was a lovely discussion video there about how I would redevelop Lightwater Valley for the families and the thrill seekers. Lovely discussion there, guys. Loved to talk about it all. And loads of different rides and attractions for families and thrill seekers. Kids attractions in there as well. And it just gives a whole new range of demographic for the theme park. Again, this is an unlimited budget series. You know, it's what I would personally do if there was a massive takeover of that park. And I was taking over that park and I had to redevelop it into a fully-fledged theme park for all ages, families, kids, and thrill seekers. So there's a few rides in there. In the future, past this sort of development, I bring in some more flat rides for thrill seekers to sort of, you know, replace the old Eagle's Claw and sort of replace that in the lineup, obviously with the Zampella Discovery Revolution that replaced it in the lineup technically. So overall I'm happy with what I've chosen, but thank you very much guys for watching this video. We do plan on doing another one of these rebuilding park series videos, and I want to sort of, obviously it's part of Theme Park Newsroom because it's discussing, you know, predicting, but there's another one I've got planned for the near future, which is about how I would redevelop the site of the American Adventure. So I'm going to do the research, look into different parts of the Wild West origins and history, and say what I think. So thank you very much guys for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and for now guys, see you guys for more in the future. My name is Coast Shell, keep living the coast of life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care guys, have a Lightwater-tastic day, and hopefully we get a takeover of Lightwater Valley and we get these brand new rides in the park.